Hello and welcome. Hank the Gaming is here with you in another video about Warframe. As you read in the title, this video is Beginner's Guide of Inaros. We're gonna check Inaros. As you always know, I take always a beginner's approach on how to use the Warframe first, and then we go directly in the second video after this one. It's gonna be the God mode Inaros to survive in the Steel Path and so on and so on and so on. Maybe in the future I make those Warframes God modes more like beginner's friendly mode builds and so on. But for now, beginners how to use and God mode build. So let's open the game and check what Inaros have for us. First thing first, we go upgrade and we can see here there is nothing. Armor 225, energy 188, health 2300, highest HP frame in the game. Shield 0 because he doesn't use any shield. Sprint speed 1.05. Duration, efficiency, range, and strength, all of them 100%. If you don't know what is duration, efficiency, range, and strength, duration is how long your ability lasts. Efficiency, how much it consumes each ability energy. The more efficiency you have, the less consumption is going to be. Range is how long or how wide your ability goes. The strength, how strong your ability or the buff goes on. This is arcanes, you get them from Eidolon or you get them from other players. This is your aura spot, and this is the Exilos, and this is the mods. Alright, for the ability, his passive, while he's not like the other Warframes, if you fall down, you're not gonna die and bleed out directly. You're gonna become in a tomb, like crossed hand like this, and you're gonna attack enemies near you. The more the enemies you kill, you're gonna take their soul and revive yourself. As much you kill them when you are in your tomb, you're not gonna be dead. While bleeding out, Inaros become a tomb to protective secure for focus. He can revive himself by draining the life force from nearby enemies and allies, as I explained you. This discation is blast enemies within a wave of cursed sand that blinds them and steal their health. So you blind enemies and you steal their health. The life steal doesn't bypass 25%. Doesn't matter how much ability strength that you have, but the range does and the duration does. And the efficiency get low with the with higher efficiency. For devour, hold power to trap target in quicksand and draw them in for devouring. This steals health and ultimate creates a friendly sand shadow. So this one, if you hit the enemy, it's gonna be a drone in the sand. If you hold the ability and while aiming, you're gonna bring him. And when you bring him, and he's gonna be like available for devour, and you can dig him in, dig his soul out. You're gonna heal yourself, becoming immune to all type of damage, and you're gonna create a shadow sand from him. Sandstorm, becoming whirling spiral sand that stands enemy flying and devour those trapped in quickness. You're gonna make a sandstorm like the mummy if you watch the movie, and you're gonna pick all enemies up, and you're gonna make damage on them. There is augment for Inaros about this one, to take the statues from your melee, for example, like viral or corrosive, whatever you have. There is augment goes with the sandstorm. Scrub sway and swarm charge that they transfer health into hardened scrub armor. Discharge to blast enemy with the scrub swarm. Survivors have their health drained and bestowed on allies. This one is straightforward. It doesn't. This one, how what it does is you consume your HP, okay, and turn it into 100% armor. Simple as that, okay. Now, let me show you how things goes. Okay, this ability blinds, as you can see. It blinds the enemies. Alright. This one, you put him in the like sand trap. Now, if I want to bring him. There you go. And now, if I hold the X on him, devour, I drink him all, and then I create a shadow. You can see, simple as that. So the first abilities, boom boom boom, blinds the enemies. Okay, the second ability, if you hit him, he's gonna be trapped. If you hold the ability, you're gonna bring him to you. And you can devour him to get lifesteal, and you become immune to all type of effects. Alright. Now the third ability. Sandstorm. There you go. Simple as that. The ultimate, I don't need to go there to show it to you. The ultimate is simple as this. You hold the key and look up. You draining HP. There you go. It will stop at 2 HP. So as much you have around 5,000 above HP on Inaros, you are safe. You get the idea, right? As much you have that, you're good. So now after you have your armor, what happened is, if you recast your ultimate, you see this? Nothing will happen. Because the ultimate is always, how to say it? It's gonna be always there, okay? But if you cast it one time only, you see what happened? You put them in a trap and you consume 25% of your armor. You need to put it back now, okay? So now if I cast it only one time, look what happened. You make them infected with the sand. And they're taking damage and they are on for a mercy attack. There you go. But as I say, you consume HP. This is why they build so much HP on him. So you can keep doing this. You get the idea. So you keep pressing the ultimate. Fill up your... to fill up your armor. Like this. You keep filling up your armor. And you keep hitting the ability. Simple as that. So now I want to talk to you about Inaros. Alright. Inaros, it's a very nice warframe. It's not the best warframe. He have a lot of HP, yes. Okay. But this, maybe you are a new player and you are wondering should you get Inaros or not. If it's, I'm going to be honest with you. Inaros for a beginner games. Like, let's say if the enemy is around from level 1 to 70, 80, you are fine. But Inaros is bad for Steel Path. But. His kit make him survive. His HP make him survive. So, when I say he's bad, doesn't mean the frame is bad. The abilities are not suitable for killing enemies. His ability are not for killing. His ability make him survive and so on. You cannot kill with Inaros abilities like, let's say, level 150 or 160 or 120, even level 80 in Steel Path. You cannot. Because his abilities are not meant to kill. They are meant to keep him survive, to CC, and so on, and so on, and so on. He have a high HP. He is a tank. He's like the definition of a tank without damage in his abilities. So if you're going with Inaros, if you are a new player, and you're just doing it for fun and missions and so on, go with it. But if you are gonna use him and main him and so on, you will need a very good weapon to go with. So he's gonna be surviving and you will need a weapon to help him kill. You cannot kill with his abilities, alright? And this is gonna be in next video, God Mode Inaros. Yes, you heard me right. God Mode Inaros. So what, Hank? You just said the frame is not good. Now you're saying it's a God Mode? Yes, because I made a lot of modification on him. A lot of things on him, and I surely tell you, you're not gonna be expecting what's happening next. I know you're expecting something, but it's gonna be something else in the next video. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this video helps you as a beginner to understand the kit. First ability, blind. Second ability, trap them, bring them, devour them, take their health, become immune. Third ability, become like a storm, pull them up in the air. The ultimate, scrub your armor and create armor and hit the ability again to consume 25% of the armor to trap those enemies and CC them. Simple and straightforward with high HP tank. Very nice tank, very good frame, but bad in killing with abilities, so you're gonna just survive with it. So guys, I wanna say thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Don't forget, subscribe, comment, and like. It means a lot, your great support. We have a Discord link on the description. Let me know in the description, what do you think we should make as a next God, beginner's God Mode next. The next video is going to be God Mode Inaros. Stay tuned, stay safe and sane. Thank you guys for watching.